Do you think you're better off alone?
Tried to make that smooth. I just kind of cut out. How's it going, everybody? Welcome to Steam Sundays. Hope you're all doing well today. It's a hot one, but that's just the way it is. My name is Pomponio, and I'm here to play some video games. Just bear with me one moment while we get everything set up. Doing some coloring, nice. You have some of those adult coloring books, I take it? Oh man, I don't know how you handle it, girl. That is just brutal heat. Okay. Of course, we're not getting any audio out. Let's see if that's... Okay, I believe it's making noise. Let me know if you guys can hear the game. Can you guys hear that? Okay, sweet. Sorry, my girlfriend was confusing me there for a second. All right, let's see. We'll go ahead and start a fresh expert run. You need to put in your earbuds. Hang on, guys. Let me just finish getting set up real quick. All right, we're back. So for those of you that don't know Tetris Effect, it's basically a version of Tetris that has music that goes to it, and it is affected by as you play the game. So the more you progress in the song, the harder it gets. So we'll go ahead and just jump right in. I've got a D rank on this level. Let's see if we can do better than 14,759. This game has really beautiful music. That's why I picked it. I figured a lot of people would like the music in this game. Thank you. Alright, it's picking up speed. Oh man, I messed that one up. This is getting bad. Ah, crap. This is not good. Oh my God, I can't believe I got to the next stage. Well, we got to 18,036. Think we can go higher? Let's see. Let's see if we can give it another shot. Yeah. That was just a bad start. This controller is sticking. Ah. Come on. Okay, so this controller has an issue with one of the buttons sticking. I thought I had cleaned it enough to where it wasn't sticking, but I am having issues. So we're going to have to play something different, I think. Unfortunately, this is just not going to be a pleasantly smooth experience. Well, let's see what we got. It's not Nintendo Day. Alright, let's see what we got in the Steam library that we could play instead. Let's see. Might be able to play some Pac Man, I think. I don't think it uses the keys that are sticking. So let's try this instead. It wasn't actually Dab that I dropped in the controller, it was soda or something I spilled on it. Something stupid. Okay, let's just. Okay. For this one, I usually play with some music in the background, so let's go ahead and get our music going, shall we? Alright. This one I don't have a very good score on. Let's go ahead and try this one. Turn it around. Thank you. Alright, so you gotta get 6 of the apples total. That's what you gotta do on this mode. Alright. Wow, that's okay. So we got 14 apples. Yikes, okay. I think we can do it. Imaging on these ghosts is really trippy. Yeah. Oh man, with 11 seconds to spare. Alright, we got another one. It's pretty fitting we listen to some trance while we play Pac Man, right? Waka waka waka.
Wash, 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 wash
Ah, 4 hours short. Woo! 11 seconds to spare again. Jeez. I got lucky on that one. So we got a 5 minute time trial? Those are all short. Okay. Yeah. I got it up to D. It's better, I guess.
Can you feel it? Let me take you all over.
It is Wednesday, my dudes. What is up, Golden Artist? What is up, Catlon? How are you both doing? Hope you're having an awesome day yourselves. Let's see if we can do better than D. I guess we can do personal best time remaining. Nice! I'm glad Lou got to visit. That's awesome. Hopefully you guys got to do some fun stuff. Okay, I actually forgot what day it was for a second and I actually did think it was Wednesday. Way to throw me off there.
Oh,
Three apples away. It is always Wednesday. Yeah, it kind of is. Nice. That sounds like a good time, Catalan. Hope you guys have some fun hanging out, you know? That was dumb. Why did I do that? About 4 minutes until we're switching games, so I think I'll go ahead and get Thimbleweed set up now. And we can go from there. Okay. Looks like they're downloading some files real quick for Thimbleweed. Well, thank you, beautiful. I appreciate the biddies. Thank you so much. You're such a sweetheart. I love you. You're the best. Oh, Cold War Museum. That sounds dope, actually. I'm a big history fan. I would like to do something like that. I Okay. So, for those of you who don't know, Thimbleweed Park is a pixel art point-and-click game that came out, I want to say 2017, it looks like, due to the copyright. And point-and-click games are kind of an old-school style of PC game. But this one has some voice acting and stuff, and I really love pixel art and pixel graphics, so really been excited to play this one. Just haven't really ever gotten too into it, but I figure this will be a fun one to stream. So, before we start, take a little dab break. And I actually gotta get my battery bank real quick. Hang on just a second. Appreciate everybody who's tuned in at the moment. Alright, we got our battery hooked up to the phone so I can keep an eye on chat. And I'm gonna just move this out of the way. You know what, we're gonna do casual, just because I'm not trying to make this a lot harder than it has to be. Basically, it's telling you just how to play the game, all the different stuff. Small town, 81 people. All right, part one, the meeting. Here we go.
Uh-huh. I fly halfway around the world and an odd note is waiting for me in my hotel room. It says to come to the bridge down by the river. This looks like the place. I could really go for some Wiener Schnitzel after the long walk out here.
I'm supposed to meet someone down here. Have you seen anyone? Are you a victim of the inferior American social support system? I have to go. I'm sorry I cannot offer you a drink. Inferior American social support system. That's my favorite. I'm gonna go with that one.
Are you a victim of the inferior American social support system?
I need some whiskey.
Let's see if he's seen anyone.
I am supposed to meet someone down here. Have you seen anyone?
Do you have any whiskey?
He really wants whiskey, but I really need to know if he has seen anyone. Telling him to sober up seems a bit condescending, so...
Are you sure you have not seen anyone?
I'm glad Chuck is dead. Ruined my life.
Wake up, sir. Wake up, sir.
I think he's out.
I have to go. Sleep well.
Boris, I'm glad you decided this is the right solution to our problem. There are eyes everywhere, so follow these steps precisely. For your own protection, leave your ID in your hotel room, go to the river down by the Trestle Trail Bridge. Turn off the light above the Trestle Trail sign so I know you have arrived. Meet at the large entrance to the underground sewers. Make sure you are not followed. Okay.
Trestle Trail to Thimbleweed Park, 1.7 miles. Trestle Trail to Thimbleweed Park, 1.7 miles. I wonder how I can turn off the light to let them know I'm here. Must be something around here that can help.
Maybe this rock can smash the light.
I wonder if I can use this rock to put out the light.
Use rock on light.
There! I've completed step 3 of the note. Now for step 4.
Alright, what was the note again? Step 4. Meet at the large entrance to the underground sewers. Okay. This doesn't go anywhere, so maybe... Oh, here we go. I wasn't sure if that water was deep or anything. Oh, I was followed. Did I lose already? Okay. At least I didn't lose right away.
So tell me again why you're here.
I was assigned to the case by the Home Office in Albuquerque.
There is no Home Office in Albuquerque.
It's neat to know.
Look, I like working a case alone. I especially don't need some junior agent messing up my investigation. Especially some junior agent that thinks I don't know there isn't a Home Office in Albuquerque. So stay out of my way. Take a lot of notes. Sit back and learn. And I'll wrap up this case and we can both get the hell out of here.
Your reputation certainly precedes you, Agent Ray.
I'll take that as a compliment, Agent Reyes.
It's how it was intended.
I'm sure it was. Let's photograph the victim and head into town to talk to the local sheriff. The body is starting to pixelate.
Body starting to pixelate.
This is going to be a long night.
Okay. So we're supposed to take a picture.
It's an instant camera, but there's no film in it. There's no film in the camera. Do you happen to have any film on you?
I do. I come prepared.
I think we'd better take a photo of that body before it pixelates any further.
Really?
Well, I need to get back to solving this case. It's an instant camera, but there's no film in it. There's no film in the camera.
Well, she, alright, what if I give her the camera?
Whatever.
She's got the film.
I think we'd better take a photo of that body before it pixelates any further.
Really?
Well, I need to get back to solving this case.
There's no film in the camera.
I think we'd better take a photo of that body before it pixelates any further.
There we go.
Smile. Appears to be a male, approximately 40 years old. Looks like he's been in the water for 24 hours. You can tell by the pixelation around the nose and neck. Let's see here. There's no wallet in his pockets. But I found a card, possibly a key card from a hotel. Now we can head into town and find the local sheriff.
Punctured in the back of the head, okay. Remember to call mom tonight. Okay. Chat, we gotta remember to call mom tonight, alright? That's key. I kinda wanna go back and look at her notebook again real quick. Got into town late this afternoon, wanna dump. I'll try to avoid contact with the locals until I see the body and figure out if it will suit my needs. Long highway. I hope I don't have to walk that again. I arrived at the body. It should do just fine as my cover. So they're both undercover. This is interesting. Okay. This is... The plot thickens.
It's a hotel key card from the dead man. The cell phone has no reception. Detective Angela Ray, senior agent. It's my badge.
Oh, you can just right-click. Okay, that's convenient. To the cursor's location. Okay. Hold down the left button to get your character following the cursor.
It's a trail down to the railroad trestle. I don't see anything up ahead. I think the town must be in the other direction.
That van say Pigeon Brothers?
It's a circus flyer with a crazy-looking clown on it. Pretty good makeup, though. It's a circus flyer with a crazy-looking clown on it. Pretty good makeup, though.
Signals are very strong tonight.
What signals?
The signals. Signals are very strong tonight.
Why are you dressed like a giant pigeon?
We're the Pigeon Brothers Plumbing. I'm Beth. That's my sister Emily.
Hi there!
But remember, signals are very strong tonight.
Yes, you already said that. But what signals?
I'm just screwing with you. Dark night, deserted road, me in a giant pigeon costume. It was too good to pass up. But the signals are strong tonight. Very strong.
This is really odd. Should I save my game? I'm inclined to pick the weirder options out of these, you know? Just to make it interesting. What do you guys think? I'm thinking maybe we should save.
This is really odd. Should I save my game?
I wouldn't worry about it. The game was expertly designed to have no dead ends or death, yet still be scary and have a sense of tension. You can feel safe exploring whatever you want. But I'd watch out for the signals. They can be very strong and disrupt the power grid.
You almost ran over a federal agent. That's a felony.
Sorry about that. Like I said, the signals are very strong tonight.
I think I've had enough of you. I need to find the sheriff and solve a murder.
Nice talking to you too. Beep. Click, 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 click. Squeak. Click, 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 click. Boop. Click, click, click.
It's a plumbing van driven by big pigeons.
Click, click, click.
No need. The perps are outside.
They're the perps? Okay, this game's a little weird so far, but I'm okay with weird. We'll go explore the cemetery later. Now we'll go to town. It is funny, like, this is a goofy game so far. It got really good reviews when it came out. I actually bought it for the art style, because I just love pixel art, you know. Just, if it's got pixels in it, yeah, I just love it.
Wait for me!
Okay, let's see.
It says Main Street. It's dark, but I can see there's nothing in there. Willie's Watch and Violin Repair Shop. Thimbleweed County's most exclusive watch and violin repair. We repair watches and violins for the rich or famous.
Watches and violins, huh? That's a very niche market, it would seem.
Howdy! I'm the Thimbleweed Park Sheriff. I don't remember calling the Federinos. That's what you are, feds. Hard to miss the government issue suits.
Alright, damn straight we're the feds. Cut the Mayberry crap, we're taking over this case. How long are you going to let that body rot in the river? I'm Agent Ray, and this is, my partner. The only place that serves good pie. I mean, I like pie. Cut the Mayberry crap. They give you some great options. It's hard to just pick one. Let's see. We might be able to pick more than one as we go through. Well, let's introduce ourselves.
I'm Agent Ray, and this is, my partner.
Nice to meet you, Agent Arenos. Looks like you heard about our little murder Reno out by the bridge, huh?
There is nothing little about murder, sir.
Ignore him. He's new.
No sense in wasting everyone's time, Reno. This cutscene is starting to get long, and it's only going to get longer.
Love how they break the fourth wall in this game. You on like, your way. A lot.
Wrestling starts at 8.
I hope he's talking about on TV.
The coroner is waiting for you in his office. Come see me when you're done. I apologize, Areno, for all the lights being off. We don't stay open as long as you city slickerinos do at night.
Even for a murder?
Especially for murder.
That makes no sense.
Are we authorized to shoot people arenos?
Nice.
Howdy who, I'm the Thimbleweed Park Coroner. Welcome to the future, who. Oh, these are the latest in crime-fighting computers made by Pillowtronics, Inc. This is all probably pretty advanced, even for the Fedahoos.
Oh, do enlighten us.
I love your sarcastic humor, who, Agent Ray.
It's not humor.
There you go again.
We're interested in any help your computers can give us. They look marvelous.
Yes, happy to explain. So happy to explain, who. Yeah, you might want to take notes.
Already on it.
Alright, let's start with the Bloodtron. Wait. Yeah, isn't this guy the Sheriff Areno?
Aren't you the Sheriff Areno?
Oh my, no. No. Well, people say there is some resemblance around the eyes. But we're as different as Pizahoos in a Potahoo. Plus, the Sheriff has that annoying Areno he adds to everything. You'll never hear me doing that, who.
Sure, whatever.
Do we want to investigate the fire portion of this first, or the... Well, let's figure out what the computers do, I guess, because I'm curious.
Tell us about the Bloodtron 3000.
This is the Bloodtron 3000. Put two bloody objects in, and it will match the blood type, printing out a report to who.
Okay.
Tell us about the Fingertron 3000.
Right, Areno. The Fingertron 3000. Insert a fingerprint registry of known criminals and a fingerprint from the murder weapon on fingerprint tape, and it will do a match-a-hoo.
Makes sense.
Oh, tell us about the Facetron 3000.
The Facetron 3000.
Oh, Monkey Island is amazing. I'm probably going to do a playthrough of Monkey Island as well at some point.
The Face
definitely
no,
great game.
Sheriff calls it.
Great game.
You who
all the Monkey Islands
Volga
I like.
Crack me up. Just
never actually finished any of them,
of
but I've played, I remember Curse of Monkey Island
match.
Is the one I started with. Okay, I was talking over that. That was dumb of me. I'm sorry. Let's do that again.
So what does the Facetron 3000 do again?
Just insert two pictures of an individual and it will verify a positive match.
Wait, so it just verifies that the photos are the same? Okay, that doesn't... Maybe I'm missing something there. Okay. Let's ask about the fire.
Did you use these computers to investigate the Pillow Factory fire?
Oh, sure did. Four computers positively showed the fire was caused by the factory guard. No doubt a who about it.
Could the computers have been wrong about the fire?
Not these computers. Oh, the state-of-the-art of who computers made by Pillowtronics. Absolutely infallible.
Isn't there a conflict of interest with Pillowtronics and the fire?
Isn't there a conflict of interest with Pillowtronics and the fire?
Whoa, now! Pillowtronics and its founder, Chuck, are above reproach. Chuck built this town and was a computer and pillow genius. Are the feds looking into this case? It was solved 20 years ago.
No, he's just curious. He's a Pillow Factory fire buff. He's got a CompuServe chat room and everything.
CompuServe chat room? This game is great. I'm loving this. This is fun. Okay, let's see. I think we've heard enough.
Fascinating stuff. I think we've heard enough. This is all very impressive, sir. This should cut hours of our investigation.
Go see the sheriff in his office for a full explanation of the amazing Arrestron 3000. I have some paperwork to do. Almost forgot. These Tron machines are fully voice activated, so if you need any information, just talk to them. It's like we're living in the futuristic year of 2017.
I hate this town.
Let's investigate these Tron machines, then go see the sheriff and get out of here.
It's empty. It's empty. There's a fingerprint kit here. It's empty. There's a fingerprint brush, a small amount of fingerprint powder, but it's missing the fingerprint tape.
Okay.
Hello again, Agent Arenos. Hopefully the coroner fills you in on our state-of-the-art Areno computers.
I'm gonna ask more about the fire from 20 years ago.
What else do you know about the Pillow Factory fire 20 years ago?
A horrible fire that killed everyone at the factory. After a lengthy investigation and corroborated to Reno by our computers, it was determined the fire was caused by a security guard.
The coroner said something about the Arrestron?
Yes, the Arrestron 3000. The last step in a fully computerized Areno arrest. The final link in the chain of a guaranteed conviction Areno. Every detail Areno analyzed and verified by computer.
Moving on.
Right, sorry Areno, I get carried away sometimes. This is the big bad boy Areno you've been hearing about. The Arrestron 3000. Just feed three reports from other Tron machines into this, and it issues a 100% Areno valid arrest warrant. Yeah, these machines are the reason we need only one law enforcement officer Areno. Chuck said that computers will soon put us all out of work, allowing for a full life of luxury.
Who is this Chuck we keep hearing about?
Sadly, Chuck passed away a few days ago. There was a big service out at the cemetery, Areno. Oh, the entire town showed up, which isn't surprising for the hero of Thimbleweed County. We'll talk more about Chuck later. I need to run a Reno and check on a disturbance call out at the old circus. Probably that stupid clown Reno again.
Looks like we need to go talk to the rest of the weirdos that live in this town.
We should split up. It will be faster.
You cooling your heels in the local diner would also make things go faster.
If we follow agency questioning protocols, this shouldn't take long.
Just don't mess anything up. I want to get out of here as fast as possible.
Agreed.
Alright, this seems pretty straightforward of what you gotta do. The murder weapon seems like it would be the hardest one to find, because we just don't... Well, I guess we could go look by the entrance where he got stabbed. We can also go check out the hotel. And go back to the body. Okay. Cornering the sheriff for idiots. That's okay. I can work with idiots. They're easy to manipulate. The Tron machines are interesting. I'm glad Reyes was a little eager beaver and took notes. I wonder if they are connected to the reason I'm here. But why is she here? And why is the other guy here, too? Appears to be... Alright, we already read that. So let's go. Let's go over here and check
just
the drawers.
A bunch of files. There's a fingerprint book here. Just a bunch of files. This has fingerprints for everyone in Thimbleweed Park. Certified Fingertron 3000 compatible.
Oh, perfect. We need that. What else do we got? Anything in here? I don't think so. Okay. Policetron 3000. I don't think they went through that.
It's a police radio. Looks like it's on and ready to use. Breaker 19. Breaker. Breaker. Is this thing on? Attention, all units. Enough screwing around. I've got a case to solve.
Okay, that was weird options. I guess we can't really use the Policetron for much.
It doesn't have any buttons. Wanted, Pickle Bill and the Cucumber Gang.
Pickle Bill and the Cucumber Gang.
Wanted, Shady Jane and the Sunshine Gang.
Pickle Bill and Shady Jane.
It's turned off.
We interrupt our hostile takeover non-stop music with this important message. Strange signals are being transmitted by the government over the airwaves. We've taken over the radio station until they stop. And now back to our special hostile takeover song.
I like the hostile takeover song. Okay, I think we've looked at just about everything in here, so let's go down yonder.
The inscription says, Pillowtronics, the brain of our city.
Mm-hmm. Oh, there's the Pigeon Brothers again.
No time to talk. We have to fix this slight leak.
What caused the leak?
Well, the Hydrotron's tube is obviously burned out. We could use a new one. A WC-67? Yeah, we're out of that size.
Must have been the signals.
Yes, the signals.
It's a bag full of plumber tools. That doesn't seem to work. Corner of Main and A Streets. It says, after 34 years of serving the Tri-Thimbleweed County area, we had to close our doors. We should have listened to Chuck. Transistors are a dead-end path. Tubes are the future. Thank you, our loyal customers.
The internet is made of tubes. It's a series of tubes.
It says, we're out at the old abandoned pillow factory. Back soon. Safely First Savings Manager, Mr. El Polo.
Okay.
All boarded up. Not even any wilted flowers left inside.
Welcome to the S&D Diner. Hey, just so you know, that article in the Thimbleweed Nickel about botulism was a smear job. So, what can I do for you, honey?
I'm a federal agent. Know anything about the dead body?
Not too much, just scuttlebutt from the morning breakfast crowd. And I don't want to get into trouble, especially with a crazy person like him.
You're not talking about me, are you?
Shut up, Dave.
What's up with this town? Most of the stores are abandoned.
Used to be the center of culture in the Tri-County area. Parties every night at the hotel. Celebrities visiting the Edmund Mansion. It was hard to not make money in those days. Of course, this was before my time. And since the pillow factory burnt down, the town is drying up faster than Dave's sex drive. Ain't that right, Dave?
What's up with the sheriff? He's kind of weirdo Reno.
Yeah, he's kind of a nut job, but nothing compared to the coroner. This whole town has gotten downright weird in the last few years. Cuckooville.
The coroner and the sheriff are the same person.
Well, there might be some resemblance around the eyes, but that's about it. The sheriff does this annoying a Reno thing, and the coroner does an annoying a who. It pretty much proves they're not the same person.
They keep mentioning their eyes. It must be relevant to something.
Don't screw with the feds. Tell us what you know.
Okay, honey. But you didn't hear this from me. I'd look into that crazy clown that lives out at the old circus. He's been out there since the circus closed down years ago. Never takes his makeup off. He's got serial killer written all over him. It all happened about 9 or 10 years ago. Ransom the Jerk was the featured act at Stupendous Brothers Circus. He was about ready to go on stage and meet his well-earned doom.
Big night tonight. Full house after my raunchiest Tonight Show appearance. I really got Johnny good, that little jackwad. It's his own fault for not being able to take a joke. I better get ready to go on stage and insult the crap out of these Thimbleweed idiots. I just need to fix my hair, put on my makeup and clown nose, find my joke book.
Okay, let's see. Needs to... Uh,
I'm not ready for my fans. My hair is all frizzy, and I'm not wearing my special ransom clown makeup or nose. I better stick my nose on. It's my clown nose, head. Ouch, that's tight. Glad I only have to wear it for a couple of hours. My hair is all frizzy, and I'm not wearing my special ransom clown makeup. I can't go on like this. Get your together, clown.
Okay, if I was his makeup.
My circus poster, featuring the amazing Ransom the Clown. That's me, face. It's a prototype Ransom the Clown doll. It's a perfect likeness of me. Well, maybe the nose is a bit too big. Very cozy. My maid changed the sheets today. My hair is all frizzy, and I'm not wearing my special ransom clown makeup. My hair is all frizzy, and I'm not wearing my special ransom clown makeup. I can't go on like this. Get your together, clown. It says, need help playing Thimbleweed Park? Call the fully automated Hintron 3000 trademark at 4468. Who needs a hint? It came off the wall.
There we go, there's a safe.
It's my closed safe where I keep all my money. That's a load of moolah.
Use the money.
That doesn't seem to work. Meanest clown of 1977 and 1978. I glued him to the table so no one can steal him.
Okay, where's this guy's makeup? I'm trying to... Oh, there's a drawer over here. Doesn't seem to want to open.
Ransom, I'm glad I caught you before you went on stage.
Autographs are $100.
Ransom, I'm your business manager and lawyer. I don't want your autograph.
Okay, 50 then.
I just wanted to let you know that your mistress is waiting at your house in Aspen. And your private jet is being fueled and ready to whisk you there when the show is over. Also, we have a deal worth millions to license a line of toddler Ransom the Clown talking insult dolls.
Did he get the liability clause waived?
Correct. They will assume all liability when the kids grow up to be beepholes.
Good. Toddlers start out as it's not my fault they end up that way. Okay, fine. $25.
I should have been a dentist.
You.
This game is great. Ransom the Clown. Okay, let's see. What else we got around here? There we go.
This goop keeps my clown fro erect. Can't have a limp clown fro or anything else.
I forgot to get cat food today, but we have enough to get through the day, so we're okay, but walk to content.
It's my special custom-made clown makeup. I am tired of putting it on every night. Sure as wish there were a more. Now there's the face I love. Ooh, my clown fro looks great now.
All right. Joke book back. Okay, so we gotta find the joke book. Let's see.
It's my Ransom the Clown swear jar with $138 in it. My contract states that I'm the only one who's allowed to swear. Anyone else caught swearing has to pay up. I don't wear hats. That's not gonna work. I can't go on stage without my joke book. I might forget my best lines without it.
swearing coaches. Okay.
It's the list of all the who swore here at this.
You shoot like a man or a little girl? You got my money, clowny?
That's Ransom the Clown, asswipe.
Okay, you got my money, Ransom the Asswipe Clown? 1,000 clams or you're not getting your joke book back. Eh, serves you right for playing the duckies.
I need my joke book. The crowd's waiting for me.
I told you before. You ain't getting it till I get the $1,000 you owe me for the duckies. Plus, $138 in interest.
Where the f*** am I gonna get that kind of dough? I have a show to do. $138 in interest, you f***ing loan shark. You are putting a squeeze on me.
Not my problem.
So, how's the old ball and chain and kids, huh?
My wife's doing fine, no thanks to you. And so are the four kids. But they still cries themselves to sleep every night after that stare you gave them.
How many kids do you say you have?
I have four kids. Why?
Oh, nothing.
Yes, me and the dab button. I'll have Jackson help me set one up when he's got some free time.
You, I'm out of here.
Alright, I think we gotta go back to the safe and get the money. That's what I believe we gotta do.
It's exactly $1,000 in unmarked bills.
Alright, so we still need the interest. At least I assume we do. Let's go give him $1,000, see if he'll give us our joke book back.
No waiting, take a shot. You got my money, Ransom the Asswipe Clown.
I have your money, $1,000.
Oh, so you decided to pay up.
Yeah, here's your money. Now where's my joke book?
Wait, are you messing with me? That's only $1,000 and you owe me $1,138, including the interest.
Yeah, thought you'd settle for less. Beggars can't be choosers.
Yeah, I thought you'd settle for less too.
Well, I choose to hang on to your joke book till I get the full $1,138.
Thank you for the bit, baby.
Now beggar off. I guaranteed to hit something.
Well, okay. Okay.
Step right this way! Yeah, shoot the foot! Win a fine leather jacket!
It's fresh out of that crappy popcorn! Must be a huge crowd in the Big Top. Hey, it's not my job to push popcorn stands around. It's fresh out of that crappy popcorn. Must be a huge crowd in the Big Top. I can't walk in through the main entrance like a tuna-headed pleb. I'm Ransom the Clown. I need to make my big go yourself. It's my Ransom the Clown swear job.
Oh yeah, there's
$138 in it.
Yep.
My that doesn't seem to work.
Pick up.
I just take the big bucks.
There we go. Okay, we got our interest. Let's go get our joke quick back.
Win big today.
He is too far away.
You got my money, ransom the asswipe clown?
I have your money. $1,000 plus interest.
Oh, so you decided to pay up?
Yeah, well, not much choice. Now where's my joke book?
Yeah, the joke's all. So how'd you get to be so famous with jokes like these?
What do you know about being funny?
About as much as you do, which is nothing. Now scram, clowny, just get with the customers. Just shoot like a man or a little girl.
I can't walk in through the main entrance like a tuna-headed pleb. I'm Ransom the... Hello, faces. I'm Ransom the insult clown. I hope no one gets their feelings hurt easily. And if you do, it's your own fault for not being able to take a joke.
Wow, so many awesome options.
What's the deal with all these Tron machines? That's some great priorities you got there. Yeah, you can't cure cancer or help the blind see, but at least you don't have to wipe your own asses thanks to the Toiletron 3000! You guys love that pillow factory. It's the lamest claim to fame a town has ever had. Paris has the Eiffel Tower, New York has the Statue of Liberty, and Thimbleweed Park has a pillow factory! You better hope to God that feather pillows never go out of style.
Let's pick on the kid with the wheelchair, why not?
Hey you, kid with a crappy wheelchair. Were you in a past life or something? Seriously, kid, you're in a wheelchair, and you got a face that looks like that? God's definitely punishing you for something.
Oh, he's crying. Let's go with the stupid mustache.
Hey, you, dude with the stupid mustache. You think you look like Magnum P.I.? A 70s porn star called. He wants his mustache back.
Now he's crying, too. This guy's vicious. Harry Mole. All right, oh, wait, there's another kid one. Let's pick on the kids again.
Hey, you, kid with the ugly shirt. Are you colorblind? Your shirt is about to give me a seizure. I mean, I'm a clown, and even I wouldn't touch something that garish.
And let's go with the lady with the hairy mole.
Hey, you, ugly old lady with the hairy mole. Or is it your parasitic twin? Whatever it is, I hope you bought a separate ticket. Because if it's big enough to ride the roller coaster by itself, it's not freeloading in my audience.
You will be forever sorry for what you've just said. I curse you to never be able to remove your makeup and to roam these circus grounds until the end of time.
He went on for another 2 hours, insulting everyone he could. Some people laughed because they thought it was funny, but most laughed because they were uncomfortable. And laughing is the best way to hide from the embarrassment of others. But after the show, in his dressing room, there wasn't gonna be any laughter.
Ha! I killed tonight! One of my best shows ever! I hope that ugly old lady with a curse breaks a hip on the way home. Now to get this makeup off, hop on my private jet, and go see my mistress Cindy in Aspen, yeah. What the? This makeup isn't coming off! The you, old lady! You up the you. Come on!
As much as he tried, his makeup wouldn't come off. That old lady wasn't just any old lady. She was Madame Morena, mistress of the dark arts. When she curses you, it's not an empty threat. Something Ransom was just now finding out.
This makeup of that old
Ransom, I've got some bad news.
What do you want, you bald, gritty little... Can't you see I'm having a problem? Grab a tissue and some rubbing alcohol and help me, you...
Your private jet crashed while trying to land. Your wife found out about your mistress, and she's taking everything you own except the house in Aspen. There was a fire in Aspen, and your house burned to the ground. The toy and doll licensing deal is dead, and they're suing you for breach. And one more thing. I quit.
What?
And go beep yourself.
And that's why Ransom the Clown is such a creep. And you should go arrest him for murder.
That's an interesting story. We'll go check up on him.
All right. Well, it's 5 till 8. I think we're going to take a short 10-minute break. But when we come back, we're going to go ahead and fire up some Pony Island. So we'll go ahead and save for now. I'm going to save down here. And we will be back in a little bit. Let me just... Alright. Be back in 10 minutes.
We'll be right back.
Alright, we are back. Trying to be smooth with that volume knob. It just doesn't seem to want to cooperate. Alright. We are going to move on to our next game. Pony Island. This one's got a little bit of a horror twist to it. It's a very interesting game. I have played through a bit of it, but it was a long time ago. So I'm just going to start a brand new game. And we will go from there. Oh, looks like this one needs a repair as well. Give me just a moment. Seventy-eight files failed to validate. Alright. Okay. Looks like I got it. Let's go ahead and play. Set up our screen capture. Let's make sure it loads real quick. Why is it not wanting to show up? I think it's working. Hang on. Okay, I think we're in business. Thank you. insert your soul to continue. Collect sin, broken STP, paywall, check soul, validate soul, soul required. Let's see here. Thank you. Anybody got any ideas in chat? Curious. It says just take one. 20 lasers. We got these four locks here, and I can't move my mouse over this thing. Inside that gray area. Oh. Wait, what? I thought I had it. Fill those first. That's what I need to do. So that they can't be moved. Okay. Thank you. What? This is definitely a puzzling one. Alright, let's try this again. I don't need a reloop. It gets rid of one of my rights. So, this one for sure. I want up here. This one I actually want down here. These for sure needs to go here. This I would prefer up here. And that breaks it again. Piece of shit.
2734. Hopeless Soul 2734. Thank you.
plot thickens in Pony Island. So now we're stuck in adventure mode, trying to get to the new portal. Well, it's 9 o'clock, folks. I think it's time to call tonight. I want to appreciate everybody who tuned in tonight. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the games. We'll be doing some sporadic streaming throughout the week, but otherwise, our scheduled times are Friday through Sunday, 6 p.m. to 9 p.m., and we hope to see you next week. Hope everybody has a great night. Take care. Be safe out there.